Hello students, so now I'm going to explain pointers in C. So I'm Anishu Kumar, assistant professor of CSE, Mathurashtra Engineering College. So what is the definition of pointers? Actually, when we use a pointer and what is a pointer? So pointer is a variable which stores the address of another variable. So that is, the definition of the pointer is, the variable that holds a physical memory address is called as pointer variable or a pointer. So point is a normal variable, but how we use an variable that like that only, but it has a special character where it holds the address of another variables or holds another address. So okay, so this is the characteristics of your pointer. Okay, so pointer is used to store the address. We are declaring or we are using a pointer to store the address. So that's the reason we are going for the pointer. So we have a lot of advantages using a pointer, but what are they? We'll see one by one. Okay, so first, next one is accessing the address of the variable. How to access the address of the variable? So we know how to read a variable into memory. So we use scanf. In a scanf statement, ampersand. What is that ampersand symbol? Is called as reference symbol, reference operator. So in C programming, we use a reference operator to access the address of the variable. So whenever we write any element or any value into the program, we write a scanf statement. In the scanf statement, what we write? Ampersand of the variable. What is that means? So we are going to access the address of that variable and to store that value into that variable. So that is the reason we are going right, we are writing the ampersand. Ampersand, what is ampersand here? Ampersand is a reference operator. It is used to store the address of the particular variable. Okay, so next, declaring a pointer. How to declare a pointer? By using an operator called star, that is called as pointer operator. So see here, data type star, a variable name. So here star is called as a reference operator, that is ampersand as a star operator. Star operator is a pointer operator which is tells a compiler that it is, I'm going to declare a pointer here. So every pointer should be declared by using only star. So star tells the compiler that it is a pointer type of variable. So here I've given an example, int star ad pointer to int. So character star s pointer to character, float star fp so pointer to float, char star 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 s pointer to variable, that pointer to the character. That means pointer of pointer, so double pointer. So we'll tell you what is this double pointer in the coming slide. Okay, so the operator, star operator, is called as indirection operator. Tell what is that? Indirection operator or pointer operator. Star is called as indirection operator, a pointer operator, a dereference operator also. We call it the three names: indirection operator, dereferencing operator, a pointer operator. So use it to display the contents of the pointer. So a pointer is a variable that contains an address of the which allocated in another variable memory. That means the pointer, what is the use of this int star ad? So ad is a variable, it going to store address of some other integer variable values, that is some other integer variable address. So if at all, if I have a variable called a, so this ad is useful to store the address of a. So or else I'm writing here int x, and I'm declaring another pointer called and int star p. So I'm declaring this star p to store the address of another integer variable. Remember which type of variable to be stored, that is which type of address to be stored, same type of pointer to be declared. Remember, so if at all, if you want to store the address of integer variable, you have to write int, you have to declare int pointer. If you want to store address of float variable, declare float pointer. Float pointer. If you want to store address of character variable, declare a character pointer. That means, so which type of variable value or which type of variable address you want to store, the same type of pointer to be declared to store that address of the particular variable. Okay, so this is clear. That means, so whenever you declared any variable or any address value, so to store that address value or to store the address of that particular variable, we use the pointer s. So we use a pointer variable to store that address, but which type of pointer to be used, which type of pointer to be declared, that is which type of variable address you want to store, which type of variable address you want to store, the same type of pointer to be declared. Sir, why we have to declare a pointer? The pointer is stores address of the particular variable. By storing address of the particular variable, we can easily access the variable value without using the variable name. So it makes us many advantages by using a pointer. So we'll see what are the advantages of pointers one by one. So advantage of pointer is the pointer enables us to access the variable that defined outside the function. That means if at all the function variable is defined outside the function, I can also access without a variable. That means somewhere the variable value will be there and variable name will be there. By using address of that variable, I can access that particular variable. So no need to declare again the variable inside this function. So directly I can access that. So without any any other hurdles of any other things, I can access that. That is another advantage of your pointer. We'll learn this about this in call by value and call by reference topic. Okay, pointer are the more efficient in handling the data tables. If you want to handle the data tables, we use the pointers. So next, pointer reduce the length of the complexity of the pointer. See, so by using a pointer of writing a programs. So mainly these pointers are used in memory management. So to manage your memory, we are going to use a pointers. So decrease the execution speed, because we are directly giving address. Whereas if at all in the normal variable, the compiler has to access the variable name and that it has to go to the variable address and it has to find the value and it has to execute the value. But whereas we are giving a direct address of the variable, so it makes a compiler easy and execution goes speed. Okay, that is an advantage of your pointers. Okay, so next, a pointer is a variable that contains an address of the which a location is of another variable in the memory. That means the pointer is a variable that stores address of the another variable in the memory. That means, so while this is only declaration of pointer, it doesn't complete your need of your pointer when you declare like this. When you assign the address of the another variable to the pointer only, your work is done. That means you can access that variable value by using this pointer. Until unless you are not assigning the address of that particular variable, which variable you want to store the address, until unless you are not assigning the address of the variable, that particular variable, to your pointer, your work is not done. You cannot access the variable value. So that's the reason after declaring your variable, you have to assign address. That means, so for example, here I'm writing in a variable called a. So a is the integer type variable. So to access the address of this variable, I want to, which type of pointer I have to create? Int star p. So same type of variable has to be created, same type of pointer variable has to be created. So this is one type of declaration, this normal declaration, this is a declaration of pointer. But until unless I assign the value, that is assign the address of the variable to this pointer, my work is not completed. That means I cannot access this value variable until unless I assign the address of a variable to p. So this is how to assign the address of this variable to p. So p is a normal variable is equal to address. How to give an address to this variable? Ampersand is the reference operator, a operator. Ampersand is the reference operator and a. So that means I'm giving ampersand and assigning address of the a to p. This is how a value of address of variable will be assigned to a point. So now I'll see here. So I'm showing a simple example here. So see here, I've declared int p, it is an integer pointer, and int x normal variable, it is a normal variable. So whenever I declared int p, so star, the memory for p will be created, the memory for x will be created. What do you mean by declaration? So when you declare the variable or normal variable, any variable, the address will be allocated for particular variable. So I'm allocating this address p, I'm allocating this address for x. Okay, this is an x variable, this is p variable. So this is type of pointer. Remember, x is equal to 5. When I've given x is equal to 5, the value 5 will be allocated here in the address. So does he have anything in the p? No. So until unless p equal to ampersand x, the address of the x, for example, the address is 2000. So this, the address of this variable is 2000. This address will be stored here in the pointer. 2000 will be stored in the pointer. That means that whenever you declare int star p and x, this is only normal declaration of variable. only memory will be allocated for particular variables. Just that's it. Whenever assign a value to this variable, x is equal to 5, the variable value will be stored here in the x variable, and p equal to ampersand x. That means the address of x is to store. What is the address of, for timing I have taken address is 2000. So this 2000 will be storing into the pointer. So remember, the pointer is only to store the address of the variable. Okay, the address of this variable is stored here. And now I have a link between p and x. So the link will be created. Until unless you write this statement, the link will not be created. Until unless you write this statement, the link between the p and x will not be created. Now I can access the value of 5. By using a p. That means, so by using this pointer operator, I'm going to access the value, variable value of 5 using a p. That is the need of pointers, by using a direct, that's the reason, indirect reference, that is, indirect reference is also called as pointer reference. That's the reason, pointer star is called as indirect operator, okay. Next, here, so by using this, I've given some of the example. Print if the value of percentile x is percentile little. So this is a normal print statement, you know. So how to print a variable x, I'm going to print the value, x value I'm going to print by using a percentile, because it is integer type of data. So 5 is the output. The address of the x is percentile u. So percentile u or percentile p, remember, percentile u or percentile p are the types first to print the address of the particular variables. If you want to print the address of the particular variables, percentile u or percentile p are the point types specified to print the addresses. Okay. Next, the address of the x is percentile u, where p is also storing address of the x. Yes or no? So x is, ampersand x is storing the address of the x, whereas p as a p, normal p, only p is storing the address of x, because p, I have assigned, what, how I have assigned p equal to ampersand x. That means address of x is assigned to p already. Yes. So that means p also stores address of x, that is 2000 again. The value of x percentile d, to print a value using in the x, it is to be printed by using a star p. For example, if you have written here int star p and x, you have assigned the value p. So if you, after assigning a value p equal to x, now I said the link between p and x is created. To print a value using a p, the pointer, the value inside x by using a pointer, how we can do that? By using a star p. So the star p is the pointer, the star p is the variable which is going to print the value which is associated with the address of the particular variable. So if at all p is associated with some which variable address, x variable address, if I want to print the value of that address by which I can use by using a star p. Star p is a variable to print the particular value at the given address. Okay, the same thing, the value of x is percentile x. So where ampersand x is, what do you mean by ampersand x? P again. So ampersand x is again p. The star of ampersand x is 5 again. So that means this is, that the reason x is called as indirect operator, because so star of ampersand of x means the value which is there at address of x, value which is there at a address of x will be going to print. So I'll show simple example here. So int same x comma star p, I'm declaring the variables and declaring the variables. When I declare the variables int star p and x, the memory will be assigned for this x. Memory will be assigned for this x and p. This, let's take, this is the address is 2000. So whenever I've assigned value x equal to 5, the value will be stored at 5 here. So next, what I'm doing is p equal to ampersand x. That means what is the value of p now? Ampersand x. That means address of x. What is the address of x? 2000 I'm storing here. So when I declare like this, the link between p and x will be created. P and x will be created until unless I will not use. So what do you mean by a star here? Star means the star of p. So p, what do you mean by p? So star of p is 2000. What is the 2000? What is that? This, the address of this particular variable. Star of address means what is the value is there at this address. What is the value is there at this address? 5 is there. That means the 5 is the value. That means indirectly, star use value which is there at a particular address, the value which is there at a particular address. If I'm writing a star p, p is, what is mean by p? The address of the x. What is the address of the x? The star of 2000 means, what is the address of the x? What is the value there at the 2000 address? 5 is there. That is what I'm printing. The same thing here also, what is done? Star of p means 2000. So what is the value at there? 2005. So that's the reason I'm printing a 5. Here also, star of ampersand x. What do you mean by ampersand x? Address of x. What is address of x? 2000. I'm going to print what is the value at the address of 2000 address? Y. So that is only. So that means, so here, so instead of printing value using a variable name, I'm going to print the value using addresses. That is only my concept using a pointer. That's it. If you understand this concept, you'll automatically know the pointer, everything. Okay, this is only simple concept. Instead of accessing the values using a normal variable name, here we are accessing the values by using addresses. We are storing that address into another variable, and we are going to use that. You are going to access that particular values, another values, by using this another pointer variable. That's it. So this is only the logic behind this pointer. Okay, next, dangling pointers. What do you mean by dangling pointers? As I said, when I assign the value here, x equal to something 5, p equal to ampersand x, that means we are assigned address of x to p. But then you have assigned some address to x to p, and you have deleted this address. Then where it is pointing? Nowhere. It is garbage values. No, nothing. So you have already addressed x value. But now what is the value here? 2000. But that in the 2000, x is not there. The value is not there. Something value is there. So then what happens? That type of pointers are called as dangling pointers. Here, so this is a declaration index where p is a pointer. So you have declared the pointer, and you assign the pointer star p is equal to some 5. Or else you are not assigned or somewhere. So ampersand x you assigned. But after some while, you have deleted this memory. So no, nothing is there at that memory. What will happen? P will have an address of 2000, but nothing will be there at 2000. Nothing will be there at, for example, so here, star p and x, int star p and int x, for example, I have created these two. So x and star p. So this is p. So whereas, again, this is a pointer variable, p equal to ampersand x. When you write a p equal to ampersand x, what happens? The link between p and x will be created. For example, x is equal to 5. So what you done? You assigned everything and you're done. So now link is created. But after some while, what you done is you deleted this memory. But the address is there here. The 2000 address is there here. But in the 2000 address, nothing is there. That type of variable pointers are called as dangling pointers. So it is referenced before, but after that it has been not initialized, not something garbage value. That is called as, but the declaration will not initialize the memory location. Memory contains the garbage value shown in the below. That is called as dangling pointers. You have assigned the pointers, but nothing is there at that pointer value. That is called as dangling pointers. Okay, one of the type of dangling pointers. You'll get a two marks question. What is the dangling pointer? Next thing. So pointer to pointer. What do you mean by pointer to pointer? So you created one variable called x, and you created another pointer variable called p. So to access the address of x, you have created a pointer, this pointer. That means p equal to ampersand x. This address, something 2000 or 2001 is there. 2001 is there here. But I want to access this pointer also by using another pointer, px. I've created another pointer called px. This is also a pointer star p. So this is also a pointer where to store the address of the pointer again, I have to declare another pointer. That is called as pointer to pointer. Pointer of a pointer is called a pointer of. So to declare that, you have to use a double star. So for example, so one pointer to be created, so single pointer to be created by using star p. That means to store a normal variable p equal to ampersand x. This is normal type of variable to store the normal variable address. But if I want to store the address of pointer again, to store the star p address, which type of pointer I have to create? Double star xy, some pointer name xy. You can give your own name. The pointer is this identifier. You can give your own name. How I identify the behave same variable name, it has been there. So now star star can be used to store the address of this normal pointer. So this type of pointer is called as pointer to pointer, a dual pointer, double pointer. This is about pointer to pointer. Okay, next, that is only I am explaining here. So what is that? I have created into main, I have created normal variable I equal to 16. This is normal variable. To store the address of the that variable, I have given a pointer called star pi is equal to ampersand I. Before I have told that int x comma, so here only you can declare star pi. But in the same way, in one line only you can assign, in one line only you can assign the value. That means int star pi is equal to ampersand of x. So you are assigning value address here only, so everything here only, initialization. So normal, how normal initialization is there? How we write initialization x int x equal to 5, like that only. So he is assigning the address. So what is the pointer type? Pointer type address. That's the reason assigning address here only. That is single line initialization. Okay, next. He also created another pointer called star star PPI. That is pointer to pointer I. So okay. So PPI is equal to ampersand of PI. That means to store the address of this. That means here to store address of pointer, he has created another pointer. This which type of pointer is a dual pointer. I can, if I print a star star pi, what is the value will be printed? Value what will be printed is 16, because the first and foremost I've created I. So I is a 16. So I've created I, and after that I've created pi. So what is the address? For example, it is 2000. It is stored here in this. 2000 stored here in this. So 2000. What is the value of pi now? What is the value of pi is 2000. If I write a star of 2000, what happens star of 2000? What happens star of 2000? The value at the 2000 will be printed, 16 will be printed. Again, I have created another variable called, another pointer called star of pi, sorry, ppi, star of ppi I have created. So what is this doing? It is storing address of this. For example, we take 3000 is address of this. So 3000 it has stored. What did I write here? Star of PPI. What is the value of PPI? 3000. What do you mean by star of PPI? What is the value at there? 3000. What is the value at there? 3000. 3000 address. What is the value there? 3000 address. It is 2000. So what is the star of 2000? What is the value there at star of 2000? 16. So it will print the value 16. Again, it is again redirecting to 16. That is, the first I stored a 16. So that is I is okay. P equal to some address value. So this is address value, stored it here. So P's address is x0x2320. So I'm taking in the hexadecimal value x2320. For example, again I assigned a star pp for this. What is the address of this ppi? x0x2324. So 0x232324. If I want to print the value at this, what happens? Star of 0x2324, the value at this value will be printed. What is the star of x0x2320? So what is the star of 20, star of x2320? 16. Automatically, ultimately, I am going to print again the value, normal variable value. If I print a star of PPI, if I print a star of PPI, what will be printed? The address of the this will be printed. That means, because star of PPI means, what do you mean by star of PPI? Star PPI means what is something? Address of the this one. So 0x2324. What do you mean by star of 0x23? What is the value is there at the 0x2324? What is the value at there? 0x2324. 0x2320. What is this? The address of the 16. The address of the 16 will be printed. Okay, remember, this is called as dual pointer. Pointer to pointer is called as dual pointer. So you can access the normal variable using a normal pointer as a dual pointer. If you want to using access using dual pointer, you have to use star star. Okay. Next, casting a pointer. This important topic is casting a pointer. First, what I've told in the first slide, if you want to access the address of normal integer variable, I have to use which pointer? Integer pointer only. I have to use integer pointer only. So if I want to access the variable of float variable, which pointer I have to use? Float variable, I have to use float pointer only. That means float variable pointer only I have to use. That means, So which type of variable address you want to access, the same type of variable value, variable pointer you have to create. But here casting a pointer makes you to convert one type of to another type. To convert one type to another type, you can do by using a casting. Here I have created int v of 1000, but and my pointer is float star p. But to access this variable, how I can access only the integer pointer I have to create, but I can convert that into float by using a float star of star v. So converting this value into float star of star v. So float star of star v is converting the normal variable value, is converting into this, and I am using this pointer variable. This is called as casting, the converting of normal one type of variable value into another type of variable value by using a pointer variable to convert. In our normal situation, what do you do to convert a normal variable into another variable type of variable? We write a casting. In the same way we are writing casting, but which type of casting? Pointer casting, a pointer star, float star. So because it is a pointer, I have to use a pointer cast. Okay, this is called as pointer cast. So next, void pointer. So void pointer is a pointer which it is a generic type of pointer, same thing. So as I said, so if I want to use integer variable address, or to store the integer variable address using a pointer, which type of variable I have to create? Int star p. This star p is going to store the address of x. But if I want to store the address of float f, which type of pointer I have to use? Same, float some pi. So p, this is a variable to be created. That means which type of variable address you have to access, the same type of pointer variable you have to create. But defaultly we have a one type of pointer called void pointer, which is a generic pointer. By using a void pointer, I can access, that means I can store address of any type of variable, but by casting a particular thing. So okay, that is called as void pointer. We'll see that. Here I have created int v. V is the integer type, float f is the float type, but I have created is g. Which type of type it is? It is void type. So I am passing a v. So what is the thing I have accessed by using pointer? Which type of variable I have accessed? Integer. By using a void, I am going to use same thing, ampersand v I have done. Which v is which type of variable? Integer. By using void, I have given address of integer. But in normal case, which type of thing only? But it is only possible only for when you create with a void. You can assign any type of variable value to a void pointer, and you can use that. But when you are printing that, you have to typecast it. When you are printing that, which type of thing you have taken? V is which type of thing? Integer. So I'm typecasting int star. Again, I have given star p is equal to g. G is which again? Which type? Sorry, it is float type. Here it has to be reversed. It is g to be there. Here p is. So to print that value, so float star of that. So that means void pointer is a generic pointer. By using that, I can access any type of variable address. That is the advantage of void pointer, that is generic pointer. That means in normal case, which type of address you want to take, the same type of address pointer has to be created. But here by using a void pointer, I can access any value addresses. But while printing or while using that pointer, you have to typecast to particular variable. Okay, so next we'll discuss about call by value and call by reference. What do you mean by call by value and call by reference? Is this comes in the place of pointer to function. So function, if you know the function concept, I can tell you call by value. Call by value is in function. So I'll call this function here, and somewhere function call will be there, that will be executed. The value will be coming from this main function to sub function, it will be executed. This is called as call by value. Normal value come from here to here, it will be coming only value. I'll pass the value from here to here, and everything will do here acting. So that means, for example, I'll tell you, this is module 1 main function. I've opened this, I've called a function a and b, values of a and b from here to, so some f function I've called here. So here a function, I wrote f function, and I'm accessing every a and b values by using a values. I'm passing from here to here A, what is the A value? For example, it is 11, B value 12. I'm passing 11 here and 12 here. This is called as call by value. That means passing values from main function to sub function to access the variable value. That is called as call by value. Whereas call by reference is passing address. Instead of passing values, you are passing address of A and address of B. That means A will be here only, B will be here, B will be here. The address of A and B you are passing to another function. A and B you are passing to another function. You are not passing a value inside the function. That means by using address, I will manipulate these values. But here, directly I am passing the values, and after manipulating everything, the values will be replaced here. Values will be updated here. But here it is not like that. Here we are updating the address values. You are taking address and updating the address values. That is the difference between the call by value and call by reference. What is thing I have given here is, so if at all if it is original value is there, I am passing a original value from main function to sub function, main function to sub function. In call by value, the modified the value call by value value will be modified. No, so here the value will be modified. You can change it. But here in call by value, what you are passing, just values you are passing, and you are calculating. For example, what you want to calculate, that value is again returning back to here. But here in call by reference, you are not returning the value. You are modifying the address value here only. You are passing address. That is, when you pass address, you are by using this variable address, you are modifying this address value, and you are printing here itself. That is a call by value and call by reference. So call by value. In the call by value method, the value of the actual parameters is copied and into the formal parameters. What do you mean actual parameters? Parameters you pass from main function called as actual parameters. Parameters you take in the sub function is called as formal parameters. Formal parameters. Okay. In call by, in other words, we can say that the value of the variable is used function call in the call by value method. So we are using functional call from there to here. So in call by value method, we cannot modify the value of actual parameters. We are not modifying the actual parameters and formal parameters. By the formal parameters, in the call by value, different memory is allocated actual and formal parameters, since the value of actual parameter is copied into formal parameters. That means we are passing from here actual parameters to formal parameters. That means here value you are passing from here to formal parameters. Here one instant will be created for actual parameters, some variable values will be created. Here another instant will be, memory instances will be created for formal parameters. So that means this address is different, this address is different. So here in call by reference, you are only passing, you are creating these values variables, and you are passing variable addresses. You are not creating another instance here. You are taking a pointer variable to store address of this, to another pointer variable to store address of this. Using this pointer, you are manipulating these values. Modifying these values. That is called as call by reference. So this is call by reference. Call by reference is address variable is passed instead of function actual parameters to the actual parameters. Instead of passing a value or passing address, the value of our actual parameters can be modified by changing the formal parameter, since address of the actual parameters is passed. Normally we are not passing another instance of values of formal parameters. We are passing same address value which is passing actual parameters addresses only we are passing. That means by using these pointers, we are manipulating address values which is there at actual parameters. That's the reason the address values will be modified. In the call by reference, the memory allocation is similar to both formal parameters and actual parameters. All the operations in the functions are performed in the value stored in the at address and actual parameters. The modified values get stored at the same address. That's the same thing I said. So same address values we are passing. We are not creating another instance address values for the formal parameters to actual parameters. Here the same address only we are passing. That means by using this pointer, we are modifying the before one. So we are modifying the last address one. That's the reason this will be modified. No need to again pass the values here. Directly print the values here, it will get the values will be printed. That is called as call by value and call by reference. So while calling function, we pass the values of the variables to it. Such functions are called as call by values. While calling functions, instead of passing the values of variables, we pass address. We pass address, location, same location of the variables, and that is called as call by reference. In this method, value of each variable calling function copied into corresponding dummy variables is called as callback function. That means each variable value will be copied. So another way, so here one instance in the main function, again here another instance will be created, that is another memory will be created. You're copying another dummy variable and you're manipulating, you're using this memory address and manipulating, you're doing any other work, and you're again copying that values into this here. In this method, address of the actual variables or calling function are copied into the dummy variables of the called function. That means same variables, but we are passing an address. So with the method, the change made with the dummy variables in the called function, we have no effect with the values of the actual parameter. We don't have any other effect by using this. So again, you have to want to print the values, you have to return back these values, and in that case only you will get the values. But here, by using this way, here in call by reference, by using this addresses only, we are modifying this. That's the reason. Okay, this is the difference between call by value and call by reference. We'll see simple example program for call by value and call by reference. So I've taken void swap. Void swap. What is void swap? Swap. So this is function. This program is to swap two numbers. Two numbers. You know already. What is the swapping? Swapping of two numbers, one between one. Okay. I've written a program using a function. Call by value. This is the method of call by value. So normal function way. This is a normal function, how a function behaves. So I've written so void swap int int. This is a prototype, you know. So what is the prototype means? But before going to program, so I'm giving a compiler. I'm going to use void is my return type, swap is my function name, and int two variable parameters I'm going to take. These two parameters are integer type. This is a prototype that has given to the function program. Int main. So int a equal to 10. So that means here only I'm assigning, I'm not taking from the output screen. Int a equal to 10. What is the value of a now? 10. Int b equal to 20. So next, print it before swapping the values. I have to show user that there is values before swapping them. So before swapping values are main, a equal to %d, b equal to %d, a and b. First I'm printing the values before. What is this? Before swapping, what is the values are there? And also after swapping, I will show. So swap of a comma b. When I call the function swap of a comma b, the cursor will redirect to where is the function swap. Some function is swap. The definition about the swap is there here and it goes here. What is the value of a? 10. What is the value of b? 10. So it goes here. Here I will show another instance here. I am creating another instance p instead of writing q. Q. So okay, so here what are the before variable variable names a and b? What are the these are called as? These are called as actual parameters. When I'm passing the actual parameters from here to here, so what is the thing will be passed from here to here? 10 will be passed to p and 20 will be passed to q. That means what is the value of p now? 10. What is the value of q now? Now again, what is that? Again, for this, when I've created a equal to 10, for this instance, a address will be created. In the a address, 10 variable values will be stored. For this instance, b will be created. For b address will be created. In that, b 20 will be created. Again, when I call from here to here, again, the p instance will be created. P address will be created. In that, what is the value will be stored? 10. For this instance, q address will be stored. In that, 20 will be stored. That means some new duplicate addresses will be stored. That means duplicate values will be stored from here to here. Here 10 is there, here 10 is there, here 10 is there, here 20 is there, here 20 is there. That means after that I am manipulating the values. So int 10 here and calling again after swapping. Here only see, I am printing here. After swapping the values here I am printing. Because to know that after swapping values of a equal to, so it is a equal to %d and b equal to %d, what is the values I have to print here? P and q, because I have changed p and q. So now, so we will see. After that here I bringing back and printing after swap values. Does it change the values here to here? No, because only this will be correct. This thing will be correct because this will not be changed. Because we are not changing the values here. We are not manipulating address values here. We are only taking a new instance of that and changing here. If I print here, I'll print. This is the second statement. For example, main statement. Function statement. This will be true because so we are printing the values here itself and we are not passing from here to here. So what will happen? We'll see. compile and run, I'll say. See here, here in sub function, after swapping, what is that? After swapping, 20, 10, it has been swapped. But before, in the main function, does it swap? No, same values are there. That means because the instances which are not changed here, because we are only passing values from the main function to sub function, and we are manipulating the values and printing the values here. This will be true because we here it will be changed, but here it will not be swapped. Here it will be swapped, but here it will not be swapped. We are, because we are not accessing the values of A and B here. This instance is different, this instance is different. That's the reason we have got the this is correct and this is wrong, because we are not passing from here to here again values. Okay, that is about your call by value. So if it will see call by reference, what happens in call by reference. Here in call by reference, what I'm doing is I'm passing, so 10, 20, I'm passing from here to here. What I'm passing? Address of A and address of B. Address of A is passing from here to here, address of B is passing from here to here. So when I pass the address, what is the variable to cache that variable? What is the variable to cache that address? Only the pointer can cache the address. That's the reason I've declared a pointer. You can write any pointer variable. So you can write star P, star Q, or if you want to write, you can change it, you can change. So I'm changing P, I'm changing Q. You wish, you can want, in which way you want, you can change it. So P, so this is another instance, variable instance. Okay, so we'll see what happens. See here, so three times, in the three times it is given. So before swapping in main 10 B 20, after swapping in main, so that is main function, so 20 20, here also 20 20, because so when I've given here the address is here, the address from here to here we got address, we didn't got the values. So here before, in this case we got the values, we manipulated the values and everything we have done here only in this function only. That means reason we didn't get the values back to your sub function, main function. That's the reason in the main function the printf statement given wrong. Here in sub function, because we are only manipulating address, actual address of these variables, we are not changing the values, we are manipulating the address of before address only by using a pointer. That's the reason. So we got the same values here and here in this print statement. This is about your call by value and call by reference. You try with some other examples, you can get more clarity on this. Okay, thank you.